Welcome, MHS and USD 239 sports fans. We're in the shivery month of December. It's the first of that month, 2006. We're here for the start of the 06-07 basketball season in Russell, Kansas, to witness the ladies and the men start their season. Ladies up first, as normal. Mike Perry and Dale Leach here to broadcast tonight. And
looking for big things this year with these Lady Lions. They're state participants last year, and I know Coach Gerald would like to repeat, get back and give it a go one more time down Manhattan.
Well, both the girls and the boys are state competitors last year, both finishing fourth, but the girls have a lot more coming back from their team than the boys do. The girls haven't lost their two main guards, basically, and seniors Perry and Atwell, and of course Katrin. But the rest of the nucleus is here, and led by all area, first team preseason all area, Jordan Crossan, who averaged 16 points a game last year and 11 rebounds, and has apparently picked up her game quite a bit over the summer playing summer ball. So we're really looking forward to seeing what the girls can do and hopefully have a very successful season. I was telling Mike, I noticed in the preseason publication that came out this week in the journal that the Lions, both girls and the boys, I think drew a very good potential substate anyway, will play at Bennington this year. And the teams will play against are Bennington, Solomon, Peabody, Canton, Galway, Elsaline, Harrington, and Wabunsee.
You know, in the past, we've always complained some sort of the draw that we have gotten. We've had some very, very tough substates in the past 6 years, boys and girls. And this could be one of the years where we have a pretty easy draw.
Well, it potentially lines up that way. Of course, I said that all fall long about the football. And that ended up being not what we wanted. So you don't want to catch chickens before they hatch. But it's potentially looks easier than we've had in the past few years, for sure. And we definitely aren't going to have to drive as far, which is very nice. Just down the road to Bennington. So that'll be nice.
Now we do have the sisters act here. We've got the Shoemaker sisters and
Jarrah and Shay.
Sisters.
And that's right,
Brittany and Connor.
This is the for the girls the 33rd year of modern girls basketball in the modern era. 1,052nd game. Seventh year coaching for John Darrow and Dale Henderson. Can you believe that?
No, I don't.
His record is 49 wins versus 81 losses. But last year they had his best year so far, 15-11. And this year they're entering with pretty lofty bullseyes on their back within the Kansas Basketball Association. They're ranked third in the Topeka Capital. They're ranked number one in Class 2A. So there'll be some teams gunning for them or hoping that the 3A ball can knock them down. But time will tell on that.
And as we noted earlier, Dale, down at Manhattan, that Hoxie team is going to be a team to be reckoned with.
No doubt about it.
Towards the end of the season.
No doubt about it.
They were quite a team then, and I think they have everything back. They were very young then, and they'll be tough.
You know, we can probably expect to receive continued good play under the boards from Donovan and Crossan and Shoemaker, Seamers. One of the keys is going to be to replace the ball handling and defensive hawkness that we had in Atwell and Perry.
team speed and quickness graduated. Mm-hmm. Yep. I think we have the ball handling. We don't have that burst of quick speed that Perry provided for us or the quickness of Audrey Atwell. But I think we'll be able, if we take care of the ball, we're going to be a tough team to be reckoned with all year long, too.
And it'd be nice if we could get some more consistent shooting from the outside, too, throughout the year. Here tonight versus Russell, this is the 36th game in the series. Minneapolis leads at 25-10. And we have a current 7-game winning streak going back to 2003-04. And it seems like that long 7-game winning streak that Russell had before that is a way distant past. When they were whomping us by 20, 30 points every time they got on the floor against us.
Bolton Shoemaker and Shoemaker can light it up from beyond the arc. So I really look for us to have, 5 or 6 threes ball game.
That would be nice. Couple that with some decent board play underneath and it can be pretty dominating.
Well, it does open up the inside when you've got somebody who can drill that three-pointer. Mm-hmm.
But as we said earlier and talking, one of the keys is we'll be pressed. And how well can we handle the press, get the ball down court, will be a big key. Be a real big key. So we'll get here with the introductions.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, Russell High School. Welcome to the Eva Sports Gymnasium.
For the opening game of the season.
The Russell Broncos.
NCAA. Action.
In accordance with Kansas State Fire Marshal regulations, first that you take a moment to identify the two emergency exits closest to you. We have checked these exits and the other emergency equipment in this building and verified that they are available for use in case of an emergency. And now, for our starting lineups, first for the Lions, a 5'7" senior, number 12, Carissa Seaborg.
Krista Seaborg.
A 5'5" senior, number 12, Mallory Mahoney.
And there's still a Mahoney.
The last of the Mahoneys.
Donovan
Seamers. Crossman. Shoemaker and Darrell.
The Lions, a 5'3" junior, number 15, Chantel. Darrell.
Carter Mahoney.
A 5'8" senior, number 24, Alexa Hyatt. For the Lions, a 5'7" junior, number 22, Sheriff Shoemaker. For the Broncos, a 5'8" in sophomore, number 34, Shannon Miller. Finally, for the Lions, a 6-foot junior, number 32, Jordan Crosser. For the Broncos, a 5'7" junior, number 41, Brandy Gloria. The Lions are coached by John Durrell. The Broncos coached by Dan Reingans. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy the game.
What a difference a day makes, Mike. Yesterday we were freezing to death.
Well, it gets up to 40 degrees. It feels pretty good.
This afternoon I could walk in here without a coat on with this nice warm shirt and not feel uncomfortable. And of course, it was, 60 or so the day before? Kansas, what can you say?
Florian will jump center for Russell and Jordan Crossan for Minneapolis. We're setting up to get the tip here, so let's look for a quick bucket.
The Shoemaker.
There we are. Nice pass over to Donovan, and it's up and in. It looked like we were going to play for the tip there, and worked real well there. Mahoney with the ball out on top. She's being hawked by Darrow. Now Shoemaker on the wing guarding man-to-man defense by Minneapolis here. Crossan's guarding Florian. Now a three-point shot is good. Miller with an outside three, and Russell takes a 3-2 lead here. Inside to Jordan Crossan. It's good. She gets positioned that deep. It's a count it. Crossing with her first bucket of the night. Arrow with the good defense out on top. Now Russell tries the baseline. Shoemaker shuts her down. And a reach-in foul on Crossing. Ticky-tack, they're going to watch her pretty close. So Jordan with her first foul, and she doesn't need to get two quick ones here.
Nope.
Number 42, Jordan Crossing, her first. First team foul.
Now Minneapolis back into a 2-3 zone here on the entry pass by Russell. And they stay in it. Oh, Donovan with a rejection.
Big reject.
Miller with a shot from the baseline, and Donovan swatted it out of bounds. Nice block shot. Clean. And Darrow with the steal, looks down court. Shoemaker's there, left-hand layup is up and in. Darrow with a nice steal. And pass to Shoemaker cross court. It's good. Shoemaker with, and that's nice defense by Jarrett Shoemaker. Tipped the ball, went off Russell's leg, and out of bounds. 6-3 Minneapolis. Donovan inbounds the ball to Shoemaker. And Russell's matching up man to man. Seamers with the ball on the wing. Walk. And you're right, Dale, I see some very, very good foot movement by Crossing inside. Her feet are really, she's got some good moves in there.
Well, that's what they said in the paper. She's really worked on that over the summer.
Crossover dribble carries it and is called for palming the ball. Footwork by Crossing in the paint. And Russell not pressing at all. Darrow with the dribble, crosses half court, now off to Shoemaker in the corner. And she looks inside, it's stolen by Russell. She looked to dump down to Crossing, and it's stolen away by Russell. Down the wing. Lady Bronca is looking inside, and there's nothing there. Now Darrow on Mahoney.
Blocked by Jordan.
Nice block by Jordan. It was up and down. Maybe he should have been a jump ball there. She went up and came down. So 2-3 zone by Minneapolis on this inbounds pass. Three ball. Rims off and Crossing gets the rebound. Now Shoemaker on the wing. Minneapolis on the move all the way to the rack. It's good. Jarrett Shoemaker, nobody came to get her. Takes the ball all the way to the basket, full length, and easy layup by Jarra. Now Mahoney against Darrow, top of the circle. Seamers tips the ball away, and we get a look here as the depth of this Minneapolis bench is going to be shown right here as Melanie Catron, Shay Shoemaker, and Brittany Fulton all come in for Minneapolis.
Seamers, Donovan, and who? Darrow, sit down.
He's going to play eight. They inbound the ball, and Fulton, if you remember, hit those couple threes last year in the state tournament. Catron, with a good defense, Crossing came to help out and blocked the shot. Goes out of bounds to Lady Broncos. Minneapolis back in the 2-3 zone. Shoemaker sisters out on top, Jarra and Shay, and both of them can light it up. Three ball, no good. Crossing over the back, not called. They're letting them play. Now Shoemaker on the move, down to her sister, Shay. Entry pass to Crossing. And Jordan was leaning the other way, could not reach out and snag that pass. 4:41 left, first quarter. Shoemaker now with token pressure as Mahoney is being hounded by Jarrett Shoemaker.
Looks like Donovan and Darrow are set to come back in. A little rest and some instructions.
Sure, Donovan will give Jordan Crossan break. Now Brittany Fulton with a good defense. Jump shot's up and in by Miller.
Alexa Heyer.
That was Heyer, excuse me. Motion offense by Minneapolis. Entry pass to Jordan Crossan. Turnaround jump shot, no good. Melanie Catherine there from Minneapolis could not pull down that offensive board. Now Mahoney on the wing to Heyer. Drives the baseline, jump shot, back rim. Nobody there on the rebound. And an easy bucket by Lady Broncos.
It's 8-7, Minneapolis.
Shoemaker looks inside.
Oh! Put Jordan in a hard spot there, didn't it?
Yeah, footwork wasn't very good there. As Jordan gets tangled up as she's trying to backpedal to get on that entry pass. Now Jera makes the steal. Passes it off to Sister Shea, and the layup is no good. And that's why you hustle down the floor.
Yep.
As that is going to be blue ball. Tipped out by Russell. Minneapolis will play it in.
Crossan and Jera Shoemaker sit down.
Donovan right.
Good.
Jump shot in the paint.
Megan Donovan.
10-7, Minneapolis. That should be blue ball. Donovan will play the ball in for Minneapolis. Darrow back in, and Donovan for Minneapolis. Crossan gets a break. Donovan with the ball, top circle, puts the ball on the floor, now over to Shoemaker on the wing. Looks inside, it's no one there. Now Fulton in the corner. Darrow dribbles out, now Donovan, nice dump down pass to Donovan. She misses the chippy. Darrow with a nice look to Donovan in the paint.
Goes to line for two.
And Donovan will shoot two.
Reinhart
with her first foul. Donovan makes the first front end and the 1-1. 11-7. Second one is up and rims off. Darrow with the good defense. And they try the dump down.
Darrow with the steal.
Steals. Now Shoemaker on the move. It's one on, two on one. She's going all the way to the rack. No good. Shea Shoemaker gets all the way to the basket.
Jera and Crossan come back in. Shea and Catherine sit down.
He's running them in and out. Everyone's getting a breather, and everyone's getting a shot at playing here. Seamers back in also for Minneapolis. Darrow with the steal. And the layup is up and in. Chantel Darrow with a quick deal. Thievery. Good to see some thievery, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. And do something positive with it on the other end.
Yes. Nice jump stop. Seamers. And we tie him up. Double team there. Seamers went for the steal, and Chantel slipped in behind for the tie-up. Possession arrow to Russell. Crossan back in for Minneapolis also, and starting fives back out there with a minute 39 left first quarter.
What's the unobvious tie-up here?
Russell coach, so evidently we got a number problem with somebody on the Russell team, and it's the JV girl that went in, number 30. I don't think they've got her number in the book. We might have a little tea here, Dale. Usually that's the case when they go talk to the coach like that, and I might be wrong. Well, they're not reviewing the play, Dale.
No, they don't want to come up here and review the tapes that are going on up here.
Like the NFL, they'll have a look at most of them anymore, won't they? Minneapolis, the third-ranked team in the state. Coach's call. Yep, that's exactly
technical.
What's going to happen. Crossman will shoot the tee. The tee would be on the Russell
team technical
bench.
Assessed against the Broncos for a scorebook error.
They start pointing at the players out there and walk over to the opposing coach. That's more than likely what's going on. Crossman will shoot the technical.
And we'll get the ball.
One guy pointed two, and the other guy pointed one. Shot is up, and
no good.
Front rim.
Oh, she gets two, huh? Okay.
Second throw is good. Nice one-hand set shot there. Up over the forehead. Nice one-hand shot. Minneapolis will get the ball. 14-7, Donovan will play it in to Darrow. Left-hand dribble as she breaks the timeline. Being hounded by Russell, now the entry pass earlier. Crossing got called for the reach in. And
double dribble is what they're calling.
Yeah, on Shoemaker. Now Minneapolis with the full court pressure. Man-to-man. Mahoney drives the lane. Kick by Minneapolis. It's going to be played in by Russell under their own basket. Two-three zone by Minneapolis. Tried to clog up that middle. Inbound pass to Mahoney in the corner. Now out front. Higher. Long shot. Rims off. And Darrow clears the rebound from Minneapolis. Got Shoemaker up the floor. It's tipped out. Evidently the ball slipped. It's out of bounds to Russell. Now Shea Shoemaker back in. And Darrow will get a breather. Chantel with some good minutes there. Steal and a layup. Now Shoemaker with the good defense on Mahoney. Mahoney goes around two and gets the shot off. No good. We have the rebound. And they just called Jordan Crossman with her second foul.
Kind of a little reach-in foul there.
In the first quarter. That's not good.
Foul number 42, Jordan Crossman, her second team foul.
And she will shoot two. First one's up and in. Reinhardt. And Catherine will come in for Crossan. That will be all for Jordan Crossan here in the first half with two fouls. She'll ride the pine. Second throw, good. Shoemaker now with ball in the backcourt. Up the floor she goes to Seamers. Now Catherine, man-to-man defense by Lady Broncos. Jara puts the ball on the floor. She's in the paint. You have to get out of there. She resets the offense. She's looking for help. Seamers now on top. Tipped out of bounds by Russell Broncos, and Minneapolis will play it in. Reach in on Jarrett, and Donovan tracks it down in the backcourt. Now 3-on-3, Shoemaker. Pass is picked off by Russell. Mahoney with the ball now, being hounded by Donovan. They called a foul on Donovan there.
Well, hey, she's gone to 1.8 seconds in the first quarter and only her first foul. It's pretty good for Megan.
You get one in there.
Yeah.
Lock. Half a second left. Minneapolis will play it in. Russell played it in. And traveling call.
Well, was it her sophomore year? We referred to her as our assassin. Remember that rift? Every team had the assassin.
And she got her money's worth.
And I asked Darryl, who's your assassin? Is it Donovan? And he said, no comment.
End of the first quarter, Minneapolis had 14-9. Russell, Lady Broncos playing pretty decent game so far.
They are. I think they're playing a lot more positive ball than we've seen them play the last few years.
Yeah. Minneapolis with a little depth on the bench this year as Catherine able to come in for Crossman. Crossman in foul trouble here early. In the first quarter, picked up two, I would say, cheap fouls, but it happens. You got to watch out because they are watching her. 14-9, Minneapolis.
Be back with action in a second. Here we go, and the Broncos will inbound the ball with the possession arrow.
Donovan, Shoemaker, Darrow, and Catron. Mahoney with the ball on the point, guarded closely by Jarrett Shoemaker. Man-to-man defense by Minneapolis. Shea with almost a steal. Darrow with a reach in, and that should be our ball as Donovan ties up their post. Darrow in the backcourt for Minneapolis. Left-hand dribble. Clears the timeline. Now Shoemaker on the wing. He's got a pick by Donovan, goes the other way, and she is fouled. Quick step by Jarrett Shoemaker, and the blocking foul was being called on
Mahoney, isn't it?
Yes.
Foul on number 12, Mallory Mahoney, her first.
And Shea Shoemaker will play it in for Minneapolis. Looks for sister Jarrett, and there she is. 3-point up, stepped up in front of it. It's a nice shot. Donovan. That girl.
Donovan, the big board.
And she had the rebound with one hand, the putback, and she is fouled. She'll go to the line to shoot two here.
34, Shandy Miller, her first. 14
foul. I like the way Jarrett went to the rack on that. Now Donovan's first free throw is up and in.
She's 2-for-3 tonight. Make it 3-for-4.
Four. Now Mahoney in the backcourt, 16-9 Minneapolis. It's a walk. Carter with the stutter step. Now Shoemaker beyond the arc looks at a three ball. Now Shea on the wing looks inside. Got the shot at the top of the key. Didn't take it. And Russell with the good defense tips the ball out of bounds.
You can see that coming the way that defense is being played, couldn't you? That pass is going to get handed off blindly, and it was trouble.
Russell staying in a man-to-man on the inbounds. Out to the tail. Jump shot, McKee, no good. Donovan with the rebound and the jump shot, put back, it's good. She's going to be tough to handle on that backside.
Yep. I thought Chantel might put up the three ball there, but.
And a 12-footer by Russell's no good.
Donovan rips one down.
Rips it away from her now. Jarrah looking down court, he's got Katrin. And they can catch up to us. Now Donovan, entry pass to Katrin, turnaround jump shot. No good, and Shoemaker with just a finger on it, tips it out of bounds as Shea Shoemaker tries for the backside rebound. 18-9 Minneapolis. 30-second timeout by Russell as Minneapolis has jumped out to a 9-point lead here with 6:31 left.
30-second quarter.
We've outscored them 4-1. No, 4-0 here in the second quarter so far. I guess he'd run up here and rub mine.
Mahoney top of the circle is being watched by Jarrah Shoemaker. Shea with a good defense. Now Chantel's back in for Minneapolis as Donovan is taking over in the paint for Minneapolis. Couldn't get a hand on it as Chantel with quick hands on the backside tips it out of bounds. It'll be Russell ball under their own basket. Mahoney first stop the circle, looks at the three ball, turns it down, now drives the baseline. She's blocking.
Katrin says, no, you don't.
That's picked off by Shea Shoemaker. Lady Lions are on the move up to Chantel. Looks inside now. Katrin. Nice ball movement by Minneapolis. Three passes, and we had a nice little shot in the paint as Melanie Katrin catches that ball in stride and just rims off.
I'm impressed by Melanie Katrin's inside moves as much as anybody as far as improvement from last year to this year.
Yes. She gets two shots. First one is no good. Nice arch on the ball. Now Krista Seamer's back in for Shea Shoemaker. Second throw, good. 19-9. Yep. She had possession in the forecourt and stepped back into the backcourt.
Jordan Grosson's in for Melanie. 5:40 to go in the second quarter.
Coach Darrow is
good. Well, I think he probably figures out he could probably afford to take the gamble in this game.
Jarrah Shoemaker, nice move to the basket.
Donovan rips it again in.
Megan Donovan.
Donovan. The offensive board and stick back. It's good. 21-9. Jarrah almost a steal. Crossing. And the shot goes clear over the rim. Donovan could just barely get a hand on it. It goes out of bounds to the Lady Broncos. They'll inbound it under their own basket. They're looking inside. Nobody there. They throw it almost. And
oh!
Yeah, I guess so. That's kind of like a face mask in football. Chantel with the steal tips it down the floor. She goes to get it. Russell just grabs her. Tries to slow her down just a little bit. It is a foul.
16 foul on the Lady Broncos, so.
On Reinhardt. And we'll play it in. Sheriff Shoemaker on the baseline.
Off Mahoney's foot.
And we'll play it in under our own basket this time. Seamers will play it in for Minneapolis.
21-9 MHS. In the Donovan.
Donovan. Good. kind of a sneaky little play. They're looking for crossing down the lane, and Donovan comes around the backside, and that was a nice little shot. Nice play by Minneapolis. 23-9. Almost intercepted by Darrow. Now Seamers with the tight defense. Lob pass inside, and it's tipped out of bounds by Donovan.
Timeout.
And Brittany Fulton getting ready to tip back in for Minneapolis, and Russell takes a full timeout.
23-9, 4:43 to go in the half.
We'll be back after this short timeout. 4:43 left, first half. Minneapolis, 14-point lead here. Russell will play it in under their own basket. Minneapolis drops back into that 2-3 zone. Coach Darrow's fond of. It's very effective on that inbounds pass. It clogs up that baseline. Crossing back in for Minneapolis, playing with two fouls.
Might be number three now.
That's foul on Shoemaker.
Okay.
Reach in.
She was right in the area.
Yes, too close.
Foul number 10, Shay Shoemaker, her first. Fourth team foul.
Blocked by Jordan.
Nice block by Crossing. Didn't push at all. Now Shoemaker.
Knocked away.
Usually that's a foul, but Mahoney's got away with a couple of them.
At least two deflections by Jordan in this half.
Fulton. And there's Donovan on the backside again. Second one's up and in. Just ripped it away from the Russell defender. And I thought the Russell girl had the rebound. He just took it away from her. And over the top is Chantel Darrow is whistled for a reach-in foul. 4:07 left, first half.
Team foul five.
Foul number 15, Chantel Darrow, her first.
25-9, Seamers back in, Darrow out. Nice defense underneath as
Donovan's showing some quickness.
Yes, I stated earlier that 2-3 zone, very effective for clogging that up. And that pass to the backside that we've had success with on the other end, they could not. We tip it out of bounds. Shoemaker ties up Mahoney or Russell. Possession arrow to the Lady Broncos, and they'll play it in one more time under their own basket. Way out on top to Mahoney. She drives to
block by Jordan, number three. That's half.
At least three blocks. Shoemaker looking inside. She's on the three-point line. Now Fulton, her shot is partially blocked. And Donovan with the hustle underneath tips it out of the Broncos' hands, and it will be Minneapolis ball. Seamers will play it in from Minneapolis. Crossing clear at the top of the key.
Blocked. Crossing with the rebound up and in.
Crossing with an easy bucket on the backside. And we're dominating inside just as we assumed we would. Now it'd be a good time to open up that outside shooting from the beyond the arc. There's a nice shot by Russell, and Shoemaker with the quick hands picks up the loose ball. Up to Fulton on the wing. He's tied up.
She fell on her foot. Come on.
Block. Oh, did I say that? 27-9 Minneapolis. Jara Shoemaker in for Shay Shoemaker. And the tie-up gives the possession arrow to Minneapolis. We'll play it in. Seamers.
3:11 to go in the half.
And there's that.
Foul number 13, Kaylin Strope, her first.
No, actually, that was a foul on Megan Donovan.
Her second.
Her second. Wrong team, the announcer had there. And Mahoney loses it out of bounds. As we kind of talked about earlier, this Mahoney doesn't really have the skills that her older sisters and cousins have had.
16-5.
In the corner now to Fulton, looks at a three. Now the inside pass to Crossing's tipped away, and Donovan grabs it. It'll be possession to Russell. Melanie Catron back in Minneapolis. We're going to apply a little pressure here.
It's 27-9, 2:51 to go in the half.
I thought we just got the last one, and now they're giving it to us again. But Minneapolis ball.
They've not scored this half, Mike. This quarter.
Pretty good defense by Minneapolis. We've had three block shots down there, and that possession arrow should be to Russell because we just had it down here. So. Now if he just leaves it there, we'll be just fine. Chantel coming back in for Minneapolis. Looks like we're gonna try a little 1-3-1 here. A little zone, this might trip up the Lady Broncos just a little bit.
Yep, sure enough, changed it, haven't we? Across the front line, we've got Seamers, Jordan Crossing, and Melanie Catron. Guard underneath the basket is Jared Shoemaker, and out front is Fulton. And I don't know what all the discussion is here, but we're wasting a lot of time.
Well, it is Russell ball. The possession arrow needs to stay the way it is, and that's what Kenny has, and he reassured Coach Darrow that's the way it should be. Now, we get our sub in. Jordan's halfway off the court, and Coach Darrow not wanting Jordan or Donovan to get the third foul here in the first half, takes a seat on the bench, even though Minneapolis now with almost a 20-point lead.
Chantel Darrow comes in. Jordan Crossing sits down. So Chantel takes the point.
A 1-3-1 zone defense can be very, very tenacious out on the wings. It makes it very difficult to get that.
Minneapolis is going to end up with the ball.
Well, I was wrong.
And they're still explaining it to the Russell coach.
Head, so. I don't think he thinks he's right either. I don't either. We had the possession down here on the tie-up. Chantel looking to pass it in. Backside to Seamers. Jump shot is up. No good.
Out of bounds. Off the Bronx.
Seamers with a turnaround jump shot in the paint. Just rimmed off. Russell still in a man-to-man. Shoemaker with the ball on the baseline, drives to the lane. It's left-hand shot up and in. Shoemaker with a nice left-hand touch. About an eight-footer. Put Minneapolis up by 20.
Fulton, nice steal.
Now Darrow on the move, left-hand dribble as she clears the timeline, looks inside. Catron was there for a second. Now Shoemaker with a three-pointer. It's good. Oh, yeah. 32-9.
Yep.
Watching that inside quite a bit. It's Dale mentioned earlier that outside shot is going to be there. That's a terrible carry. Not called. I'll tell you, when they throw that ball inside, we collapse.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't notice if we were still in that 1-3-1 or if we had gone man-to-man.
Number 12, Krista Seamers, her first.
Seymour's first foul. Now Jarrah Shoemaker in for Minneapolis. She can throw up a three ball. 1-1.
Well, I can throw up three ball too, but did it go in?
First one, no good. Lockout by Catron, and Russell able to maintain possession. Inside the arc, two-pointer by Russell is good.
Tit for tat on the three balls there.
Chantel with the baseline move. Now Catron with a hand on that rebound.
1:30 to go in the half.
1-3-1 zone defense, Minneapolis.
Oh, that did. They only counted that as two. That wasn't
a
three ball.
She was inside the arc.
It's the only points they scored this quarter.
Long two-pointer now down to Seymour's baseline move. She has
blocking position. Foul on 41.
And that'll be a 1-1 for Krista Seymour's.
Foul number 41, Brandy Florian, her second.
1-1 for Krista. Coming
17
up.
Foul.
Both teams with 17 fouls here in the first half, both in the 1-1 with a minute 14 left first half. Seymour's first throw is good. Oh, just rims off. I thought it looked good from here. 32-11, Minneapolis.
Had the right arc, the right trajectory, looked like.
Entry pass down low. Florian throws it off the backboard. Catron with the rebound, reach-in foul by Carter, I believe. Higher with the reach-in foul. Be her first eighth team foul on Russell.
Higher, her first eighth team foul.
And Melanie Catron will go to the free throw line, shooting 1-1. First one, good. You know, if you're ranked in the top 10 in the state, you should be beating 10 teams by 20.
Mm-hmm. 2-3 for Melanie tonight.
Good.
3-4.
3-4. Free throw shooting, very, very good. A couple of girls both are 3-4. Chantel with a good defense. Brittany pointing on the wing in this 1-3-1. Boy, we collapsed real well. Three-pointer by Russell. It's no good. Chantel closes down the lane for the rebound. Back out front. Brittany with a long three-pointer. Just a half a step beyond her range. And Chantel with the steal back to Seymour's. Now Shoemaker with the ball. Nice drop down pass to Catron by Shoemaker. And Catron with the easy bucket, 36-11. Mahoney looks at a three, it's not there.
Tipped away by Fulton.
They don't get a shot off, and that's the end of the first half. Minneapolis 36, Russell 11. On a pretty decent first half by the ladies. Shot the ball fairly decent inside, and free throws were really good.
We'll try out scoring the Broncos 22-2 in the second quarter.
Really decent job.
That's pretty decent night's work there in that second quarter. Yes. What you think?
Yeah, 36 points in the first half. Minneapolis strutting their stuff.
I can remember many a game that the Minneapolis girls have played. If they got 36 in a game, they were doing good.
Yep.
So, well, we'll get some unofficial stats tabulated here, and we'll be back.
Point-wise, we sure scored quite a bit of points inside with Catron, Crossan, and Donovan.
Sure enough.
And then started to look at the outside shot there towards the end of the second quarter as Shoemaker hits the three ball. So Dale will put together some official stats here, and we'll be back with those here in just a minute.
Okay, here's your unofficial stats for the first half. Again, in the first quarter, we outscored the Lady Broncos 14-9, and in the second quarter, we really put the hammer down, outscoring them 22-2. Scoring so far for the Lions are Chantel Darrow with 2 points, two rebounds. Melanie Catron, 5 points, one rebound. Jordan Crossan, 5 points, two rebounds. Jara Shoemaker, 9 points, one rebound. And Megan Donovan, 15 points, six rebounds.
Wow. I didn't think she had that many points. But...
Wait a minute. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Yep, 15. Yep, it all adds up. 36 points.
Very impressive first half by the Lady Lions as they jump out to a 25-point lead on the Lady Broncos. Three-ranked team in the state, Minneapolis, with some great, pretty good depth on that bench, able to bring three very seasoned players in to spell the starters, and we don't lose much. Subs come in.
The only questions I haven't seen answered tonight is we haven't been pressed, so I don't know what we can do with handling the ball against the press, and I don't think we will be pressed this game.
No.
Shooting from the outside hasn't been fantabulous yet. You know, had a couple nice shots, but really haven't demonstrated any tenacity to try to shoot from the outside either.
Haven't really had the need to do that.
No.
Donovan scoring 15 inside.
What a presence she's been.
Yeah.
Knocking the ball away. She had one, at least one block, maybe two.
Crossan had three blocks. Down.
Chalked shot. Four. Crossan had three blocks at least. A lot of nice put-ins there by Donovan to lead the Lions to 15 points in the first half.
Well, we'll be back with second half action here as the boys warm up. 5 minutes to go yet. It'll be an interesting game as the boys take on Russell. Looks like Russell's got some size down there.
Yes, they do.
But size doesn't mean everything with the Minneapolis team. As you can tell in the past, they have been blessed with a lot of
and this
loop left.
Yeah. So. This one guy wasn't too bad for him last year. It's right out here on the point right now on the side. He was a decent inside player for him. Okay, we're back for the second half. Leading by 25 points.
I guess we can put the cruise control on and...
I hope so.
I don't believe we'll see one at the buzzer to put us into overtime. Possession arrow to Russell. Minneapolis.
Steal by Seamers.
Nice pass by Shoemaker at the backside. And Darrow, this is a chippy reach in by Donovan, not called. And now Russell with the ball. Mahoney clears the timeline. Minneapolis man to man. They throw one up. Seamers on the backside claims the rebound. Now Shoemaker on the move. Pulls back as it's one on three. She looks at the three ball. It's off the front rim. That is not backcourt. She did not have possession in the front court. Close. If it was on the line. Mahoney now in the paint to...
Well, they matched their second quarter output so far.
Carter, excuse me, with now Darrow with a nice shot on the backside is hammered. She'll get two shots. Foul called on Lady Broncos. Darrell's first throw is no good. Chantel, a little better look this time. There you go. Good. Pressure by Shoemaker, and Russell just about throws it away. Knocked away by Donovan. Now Darrow, crossover dribble, left-hand dribble as she clears the timeline. On the wing, the Seamers drives the baseline, jump shots up, rims off. Foul on Shoemaker. For the rebound, is called
foul number 22.
Jarrah's first foul.
First team foul.
Walking dribble by Mahoney. Zero has her now on the wing. Donovan way out on the wing on defense. Shot's no good, and Darrow claims the rebound for Minneapolis. Looking to push the ball. She has Donovan. Now a nice dump down pass to Crossan. Tipped out of bounds by Russell. Minneapolis ball right there under her own basket. 37-13.
Nice turnaround pass underneath by Donovan there to a wide open Crossan.
Jump shot rims off, and Donovan claims the rebound. Is tied up by Russell. Possession arrow to Minneapolis. And we'll play it in right there. Seamers to play it in for Minneapolis. Backside, Donovan's shot is partially blocked. She gets it off anyway. Now Crossan. They're all
good Crossan over the back there, I think.
No, they whistle Russell for the foul.
Oh, really?
Call it on the floor. And Carter.
Foul number 21, Julie Carter, her second team foul.
And they get Donovan with the foul.
Number three on Megan.
Russell adamant about staying in that man-to-man defense as we play the ball in under our own basket. We have got some easy shots. And speaking of easy shots, Russell with a nice pass down low, and they get an easy bucket.
Well, they've scored us 4-1 so far this quarter.
Donovan, top of the key, jump shots, no good. Seamers over to Crossan, that's up and in.
Jordan Crossan.
Nice rebound by Seamers there. Feed to Donovan, to Crossan, I mean.
Donovan now with three fouls here in the second half. Minneapolis in a 2-3 zone now as Mahoney throws it away. Darrow is
crossed. Seamers tipped it out. Picked up by Darrow.
And Chantel lost the ponytail and a half pound of skin.
Foul number 21, Julie Carter, in third.
39-15, Carter's third foul as Shea Shoemaker comes in and Melanie Catron. Donovan goes out. And Chantel will move down to the wing, and Shoemaker will take the point. The older variety now on the wing to Shea. Looks inside. She's got Crossan right there, and we got Russell with the hold on Crossan. She's a little bit hard to handle down low, isn't she?
Yep.
Gave Shoemaker a good look. The entry pass is right there, and that's Miller's third foul. Shoemaker to play it in for Minneapolis. Chantel with a nice shot from the wing. It's up and in. 12-footer by Chantel Darrow. Hammer. hammers it down to give Minneapolis a 41-15 lead. There's the pick on Chantel. Minneapolis man-to-man.
Chantel scores some nice quickness on defense.
And the backside shot by Russell is up and in. Florian with the shot. Crossing not wanting to catch that third foul. Now Shoemaker with the ball on the wing, puts it on the floor. One dribble and stops. Bounce pass to Crossing, it's out of bounds.
Nobody wanted to come help her.
She picked up a dribble after one dribble and they had her. Russell with the ball.
Yeah, she did, but again, nobody wanted to come help her. You gotta, when you, they do that, you gotta come bail them out.
Mahoney with the drive and the jump shot is no good. It's out of bounds to Minneapolis. Donovan back in for Minneapolis. Crossman will get a breather. Brittany Fulton in for Minneapolis also. Foul on Russell counts with reach-in foul on Fulton. 15 foul on Russell. And Minneapolis will play it in front of Coach Darrow. Shea Shoemaker will key the ball for Minneapolis. Skipped out of bounds by Russell, and it will stay with Minneapolis. 41-17, Minneapolis, 3:46 left third quarter. Shea Shoemaker played in for Minneapolis. Gets it to Brittany Fulton, and she's sandwiched. And called for the reach-in foul.
Jarrah.
Jarrah's.
It's her second.
Second personal foul.
Foul number 22, Jarrah Shoemaker, her second.
1-3-1 defense for Minneapolis here. Russell throws it all the way down to the corner. Now back to Mahoney.
Kind
shot
of a
is no good.
Deflection there by Shea, maybe.
Jarrah crosses over to the other side of the court and reach in, tipped out of bounds by Russell. It'll stay our way. Blue will play it in under their own basket. .320 left. Shoemaker to play it in for Minneapolis. Clear out on top to Chantel. Back to Brittany Fulton on the wing. Shot is partially blocked. Takes a little bit too long to get that shot off. Now Chantel. It's 2-on-1. Crossing with the rebound on the missed layup by Russell. Mahoney with the push as Chantel is fouled by Mahoney. Her second foul. Fulton will play it in for Minneapolis. Shoemaker now entry pass to Crossing.
Blocked.
That really should have been a foul. They had her on the wrist. And Jordan Crossing is whistled with her third foul.
Foul number 42, Jordan Crossing, her third.
Going after that loose ball.
Fourth team foul.
Cross court pass to Mahoney. On the wing, almost intercepted by Donovan. It is tied up by Chantel Darrow. Quick hands. Seamers back in now for Minneapolis.
Possession arrow to the Bronx.
41-17. Still in that 1-3, one zone. No, it's 2-3 zone now. Seamers with the good pressure on Mahoney. Long two-pointer by Russell, no good. Tipped out, Rutt, and Shea Shoemaker controls the ball for Minneapolis. Chantel with the ball out on top now. Seamers, entry pass to Crossan. She's fouled as she was the last time down. This one's called. She'll shoot two.
Foul number 15, Kelly Ogle, her first.
Goes the line for two. She's one for two tonight so far.
Well, this will be a good chance for her to improve that percentage. 2:07 left. Crossan's first throw is good. 42-17. 25-point lead for Minneapolis. Russ, a little out man here tonight as Minneapolis. Second one is up and in, scoring in the paint about every time down the court if they want to.
43-17, 2:07 to go, third quarter.
Coach Darrow is put to him. Now a little zone full court trap here as Mahoney getting ready to get trapped, whether she does it. Now Carter way across the other side. Mahoney with the ball, tipped out by Donovan.
I'm sure some people might be wondering, why in the world are we putting on a press when we're up by 43-17? But first game of the season, you got to start practicing this stuff on somebody other than yourself.
Yes. Man-to-man defense now by Minneapolis.
Tied up by Seamers. Possession arrow to the Lions.
Well, they're going to show her the ball. She's going to take it. Seamers with the quick hands now is replaced by, nope, she stays in. Shea Shoemaker goes out. Donovan plays it in for Minneapolis with a minute 45 left, third quarter. Chantel, crossover dribble on the wing to Shea Shoemaker. She drives the paint. She's hammered.
Jera goes the line for two. Her first free throw attempts.
Foul number 11, Kyla Reinhardt, her second.
Her second.
Eighth team foul.
Well, Minneapolis in the 1-1 the rest of the way here as Shoemaker gets two shots. First one, front rim. Will get the second one. That's a better looking shot. Missed, and Darrow gets the rebound. Karam came off to the wing. Seamers now with the left hand dribble on the wing. Pulls up for the baseline jumper. No good, and Darrow with another rebound.
Five rebounds for Chantel tonight.
Nice dish down pass to Katrin, and she misses the backside shot, goes over the rim, and Russell with the rebound with a minute left in this third quarter. Cross court pass. Russell is taken away by Donovan, and Russell, Lady Broncos, we're shooting free throws, so this might get long.
Mm-hmm. 57 seconds to go in the third quarter. Ninth team foul.
Foul number 40, Katie Rohleder, her first. Ninth team foul.
Nine fouls already this half by Russell.
And a few that weren't called.
Donovan's first throw is up and back rim. Mahoney, one on two.
There's another foul on Megan. Number four.
Reach in foul by Megan Donovan and Coach Darrow.
Foul on number 13, Megan Donovan, her fourth.
Brings in Jordan Crossing, has three, so both the inside presence of Minneapolis players are foul trouble. Way out front. Shoemaker runs it down, will get an easy layup. Pass, the inbounds pass by Russell went clear out over front the midcourt line, and Shoemaker chased it down for an easy layup. Now Mahoney with the ball in the corner. Shoemaker now with 11 points for Minneapolis.
Nice steal by Jordan.
Left hand, nice pass to Darrow. She saves it. Seamers, jump shot, 8-footer, good.
Krista Seamer.
47-17, Minneapolis now with a 30-point lead. Back in that zone, Minneapolis intercepts and Crossing's fouled. And she will shoot two now in the double bonus.
No more of this one-on-one stuff.
Two, the rest of the way, make sure the coaches
Brandy Florian, her third.
Give them instructions to
team foul.
No more fouls.
1.9 ticks on the clock here in the third quarter.
Not as many fouls as they've had. Somebody's got to be fouling out here before too long. Crossing with two throws here. First one is good. Nice stroke by Jordan Crossing. Has hit her last three in a row.
4 for 5.
Last four in a row.
5 for 6. Forty-nine to 17 after three quarters.
Started out a little slow, but after they got rolling, they put some more points on the board there in the third quarter. Minneapolis out to a 32-point lead. We're probably going to see, I would assume, that, you know, it's always good to practice against another team and get as much game time experience as you can for some of the girls that don't get to play that much. So,
well, compared to our second quarter, the scoring pace went down quite a bit there. We outscored them 13-6 that quarter instead of 22-3 in the second. So
they announced the fourth quarter will immerse you.
Continuous
really
clock. Yeah.
So
I think that is anytime you get
ahead 30.
Yeah, ahead by 30 points in the fourth quarter, it's a continuous clock. Not in the third quarter, but in the fourth.
Crossing, Shoemaker, Shoemaker, Seamers, and Fulton for Minneapolis as Chantel, Donovan, and Katrin catch a breather on the bench. Seamers with a quick hand in, tips that ball out of bounds. Just let her run, boys.
Get us home early tonight.
It's that much closer to a cheeseburger. Cross court pass and the backside shot is there.
Reinhardt
with the easy bucket. Shoemaker with the ball as she clears the timeline. Russell still on the man to man. Shea Shoemaker, nice dump down pass to Crossing. They had to come get her. She had her man beat, and a nice pass to Jordan Crossing, starting to build up some point totals now. Now the pass down under is out of bounds as Mahoney tries to hit the baseline. Reinhardt's tall, not that tall. Now Shoemaker. 6:50 left, fourth quarter, Minneapolis 51, Russell 19. Seamer is now over to Shea Shoemaker, looks at a three ball. Her sister won't turn it down. Baseline drive by Jera and a 3-second call.
Jera goes to the line for two.
3-second call.
Oh, okay.
Mahoney with the ball out on top. Shoemaker pointing in the 1-3-1 zone. Now in the wing, Seamers with the Hawking defense. Cross court, pass is...
Obvious foul. Number one on Krista, I think.
Reinhardt was there. Seamers ran into her and is called for the push.
Foul number 12, Krista Seamers, her second.
Her second. I missed one earlier.
16 foul.
Back into the 2-3 zone on the inbounds pass. Mahoney clear out on top. Shoemaker with the defense. Baseline shot. No good. Fulton with the clean out on the rebound. Goes to Shoemaker now. 12-footer down the lane. Shoemaker in and out. Quick hands by Crossan on the stick back. Just rolls off the rim. I thought Shoemaker's shot was down. It was in and out. Almost.
My. Oh, looked like pretty solid from here.
Goodness. Nice block shot by Jordan Crossan, and she caught her with the body.
Number 42, Jordan,
it's her fourth.
Crossan, her fourth. 17 foul.
First shot's no good. Mahoney. We'll get the second one.
New fresh five come in.
Donovan Darrow.
Katrin.
Fulton. Connor
Fulton and Buckles.
Amber Buckles, the way she played in the JV game, I'd put her in there too. She just played her heart out. JV game, second shot's no good. Donovan tries for the rebound, doesn't get it. Now Katrin and Connor Fulton with the rebound. For Minneapolis with the ball on the wing to Chantel. Now Buckles. Connor Fulton, shots no good. Open look from the wing. Mahoney now. Tipped twice and the last one was off Russell. Minneapolis ball, 3:33 left. The clocks are running. Chantel with a left-hand dribble as she crosses the timeline. Now back to Donovan on the wing to Buckles. Amber Buckles looking inside. Connor Fulton with a good look at the top of the key, and that one rims off. Connor with two good looks, two better ones she got the whole JV game, I think. Timeout by Russell.
A 30-second timeout taken by the Broncos.
51-19.
Russell with the ball, top of the circle. Minneapolis with a 1-3-1. Kendall Perry in. Morgan Halderson. Connor Fulton. It's the JV except for Melanie Katrin, and it's tipped out of bounds. Ball to Russell. Some of the JV girls getting in here with 2 minutes left in the game. Tipped away by Melanie Katrin, and Connor Fulton gets mugged, and they call a tie-up. Possession arrow to Russell. They'll play it in under their own basket. Minneapolis in that 2-3 zone. Buckles, Perry, Fulton, Katrin, and Halderson. For Minneapolis, 2:05 left. And they're going to give the ball to Minneapolis. Buckles inbounds it to Connor Fulton. Curry with the ball on the wing. And Amber is mugged as she comes to get the ball. Minneapolis will throw it in. Kendall will throw it in for Minneapolis. I would guess so. 41, I think, is trying to foul out.
She's had enough tonight, huh?
Yeah, she's had enough. Florian, and I believe she did. She's been guarding Jordan Crossan all night.
41, Brandy Florian, her fourth.
Nope, just her fourth. Buckles gets two. First one just rims off.
Clock's running down to a minute here.
Amber with the second throw here is rims off. I thought that one was in. Now, steal by Connor Fulton.
Pull her pivot foot.
And ball will be Russell's with 30 seconds left in the game. 51-19. 1-3-1 zone.
Connor Fulton with a reach in foul, maybe?
Try to put that ball on the
And the clock's going to expire here during. Oh, they did stop it for a timeout. Why did he need the timeout for? I don't know. But.
Foul number five.
12.1 ticks on the clock. It's 51-19, Minneapolis.
Miller now with two throws for Russell.
Or one. Oh, he wanted to get the free throws in. That's why he called timeout.
First one's up and in. 51-20. Second throw in and out and in. 51-21, and if they start the clock, that should be probably the way it ends. Buckles with the ball on the wing. Katrin, and stolen by Russell. And Amber Buckles knocks it out of bounds, and that's the way it's going to end. Minneapolis with a 30-point victory here in Russell as the number three-ranked Minneapolis Lady Lions win it. 51-21.
They outscored us 4-2 that quarter.
Could have been a lot worse.
We'll be back with the stats. All right, to review our stats, our unofficial stats. Again, the final score was 51-21, a nice 30-point victory. Scoring by quarters, it was Minneapolis 14-9 in the first, 22-2 in the second, 13-6 in the third, and Russell outscored us 4-2 in the fourth quarter when the clock was running. Scoring for the Lions tonight, 2 points for Krista Seamers, 1 rebound. 5 points, Chantel Darrow, 5 rebounds. 5 points, Melody Catron, 0 rebounds. Shay Shoemaker, 0 points, 3 rebounds. Jarrah Shoemaker, 11 points, 1 rebound. Jordan Crossan, 13 points, 5 rebounds. And Megan Donovan cooled down in the second half, 15 points, 7 rebounds. 0 points and 1 rebound in the second half after starting out with 15 points and 6 rebounds in the first, so she cooled down a little bit there, but that really got us off big in that first half, her effort there. So a nice, impressive opening win for the Lady Lions here, going 1-0 and increasing their winning streak over Russell to 8-0. And getting ready for the Blue and Gold Classic next Monday afternoon in Salina against El Saline at 3 o'clock.
be there or be square. These Lady Lions ranked first in the state, third in the state in the coaches' poll, so we got a decent team, and it should be fun to watch all year long. And the guys come on the floor, and we'll start them in about 20 minutes.
We'll be back with game number two with the boys. Thanks for watching here on Channel 37.